There we go. So I don't even know if anyone's watching yet, because I can't actually tell. Actually, I can probably say if I just go to our Twitch page. But right here, right now, I am gonna grind our Digimon that we've got right now. Just a can't remember what this guy's called. I think it's Dodomon or something like that. Yeah, Dodomon. We're gonna become a Leomon. That's gonna be fun. And then from Leomon, we're going to become a Banjo Leomon. Oh, phew. Mikey edited the page name, which I did not think to do. Alright. So first things first, I'm going to want to get up a guy that tells me what stats I actually need. Because I had one up before. This will only take me 2 seconds. I've been on this guide about 200 times because the last time I had to grind. Gomamon. Yep, Gomamon can turn into Leomon. We just need high attack. Okay then. Since last recording session, I think I've figured out a way to fix all of my weird controller issues. I just turned the dead zone way up, which should hopefully fix that issue there. Hopefully the audio here is just, whoa, we have a lot of offense already. I don't even think we need to train anymore. But Banjo Leomon needs 400, so I'm just going to go as high as I can. You know what, I might actually get all the stats way before we ever get to the form that we need to be. Just because of the training manual. There we go, already this weird guy. I can't remember which one was the moody one. Oh hey, yep. Yeah, this started just 2 seconds ago. Hi there, Rosebit. I've only really been doing 2 offense training sessions in the past couple moments. How are you guys? I've been alright, if you were wondering. Wasn't looking forward to this right here, because if there's anything I don't like doing in a game, it's grinding. And you know what? Just for posterity, let's see what the rate is. The rate is awful. It's always awful. That bastard Megadramon. He went and put his ill-gotten gains from weird, like, protection funds. He took it all and he put it straight into the meat market. This town's a bloody tyranny town. That's all you know. Yeah, Wanyamon's a pretty cool looking guy. He's probably one of my favourite new babies that I've ever seen. Or toddler training, whatever level. And that is my front door. I'll be right back in 2 seconds. I did not expect that. Oh, I got beat to the... Alright, I got beat to the door. Which is not something I ever expect. Since I live right next to the door. Alright, so we've got our food. We've got our happiness. Have we got porta potties? We have. We've not got a lot of money. Alright, we want to go back to the gym. Grind that offense right up. So yeah, Try. What did you guys think of Try? If you haven't watched it yet, you should probably go watch it. I thought it was very good myself. It's very, like, sort of moody and dark in tone, though. I mean, like, the visuals obviously were not, but the story, nobody seemed happy in any way, shape, or form, which is, you know, a bit odd for a children's, well, it's not really a children's show, it's kind of now aimed at people way older than children. It's a callback to a children's show from the 1990s, so it's probably aimed at 20s to 30s, but yeah, I agree with us, but it was awesome. The animation in it was very, very top-notch. Good stuff all around there. It just looked fantastic. All the colours were bright. Nothing looked dodgy. But yeah, they matured, like you say. They matured the show. It's much more adult-feeling. I'm not actually sure how old the characters in it are meant to be. Are they meant to be like 14, 15, 16 sort of age? Joe seems like he's meant to be about 18 in it, which is not expected, to be honest. Yeah, very good show in general. Ty is 17, bloody hell, they're way older than I expected. Way, way older. Like, I was expecting 14. But yeah, I like where they're going with it right now, I'm looking forward to seeing where it continues to go. Fortunately, I have no idea, actually, I need to be feeding him more than just that. I need to get his weight up to, I believe, 40. So let's just crank that up with a saloon. I've got a heavy strawberry, which I could feed him. Got 13, so we're a quarter of the way there. By the way, just give me a quick notification. Is the audio alright? Is the balancing fine? Because I don't know if it is. I haven't really got many good ways to test it. Alright, so we've got 200 offense, which is all we need for now, and we are on 90 speed. We don't want to get any more speed, because, Psst! Mateo! Just Google. Watch Digimon World. Digimon Adventure Try. Just do that. You'll find it all for free. It's the internet, man. I mean, like, I'm not a big fan of advocating piracy, but it's really easy to find it. Ah, here's the guy that we want to be. He's gonna... Look at him, man! He's a businessman! He's the old guard of capitalism right there. Bloody hell. He's not got anything that we want right now, though. Hi, Destinario. Welcome to the stream. Welcome to everyone, by the way, who's watching right now. If you wonder what we're doing, if you're just some random Twitch person who doesn't know what this is actually from, this is part of a Let's Play of Digimon World Re Digitized. We are up to... this will presumably be the 33rd episode. We're nearly at the end of the game, and basically we're going to turn this Wanyamon into a Bancho Leomon, and then from there, we are going to turn him into a Chaosmon, because we just had a Darktramon. In fact, that reminds me. Digimon me? Ah, look at that guy. We have some quite cool guys in our Digimon me here. I don't think they're the kind of ones you usually get this early in the game. But yeah, let's set him to that, because then when we digivolve to Bancho Leomon, we'll just immediately get... we'll immediately get what we need. We'll be able to Jogress. So, I can't raise speed anymore, because we are at the speed cap before we accidentally activate a potential second digivolution. So, what I'm going to try and do here is... I'm going to go think of somewhere that we can go fish. Yeah, alright, I'll do that, Mikey. That's a good suggestion right there. There we go. It was only really covering the, covering the happiness bars, but you are right, there's more going on the other side. On the side that the chat was already on. And I need to bring up chat again. There we go. Yeah, you should definitely watch Try a Scenario. It's only about... It's probably about an hour and a half's worth of programming right there, because it's all about 20 minutes long, but it's definitely worth checking it out. Alright, so fishing. Where's a good fishing spot? I know I can go this way and to the left, and you've got the entire crappy fishing area. But hey, we might just digivolve that now, so it's not a problem. And this is where I try and remember what my save state keys are. To save the game. Yeah, let's save it. And... we did not digivolve, but let's try and find out what my... That's load state. Great. Good thing I just saved the game, eh? No. Alright, if you're wondering why I just checked out my state, it's because... yeah. Because basically, I don't want to accidentally make a single mistake. There we go. And lose about 2 hours worth of work and effort. Because, simply put, I don't have a lot of time right now. I'm kind of in the middle of the last 2 weeks of this year's worth of university, so I think Americans would have finals. I just have huge fuck-off assignments I have to write. 2,000 worders right there. That's back to the beginning area. Shantae theme. I don't know the Shantae theme. Am I supposed to know that? I thought I fixed the control weirdness, but I guess I didn't. Yeah. I study political science at University of Birmingham. I've basically got to write a 3,000 word assignment on the values of Vol's theory of justice compared to, say, libertarianism, or, well, not specifically libertarianism, Nozick, or something like that. Or something else that's kind of contrasting to Vol's. Just remember that I can't walk through the pylon, even though I should be able to. But yeah, not looking forward to writing that one, since I've attended like half the seminars for that class this year. I've also got to write... No, it's not... That's not what I've got to write in the next 2 weeks. It's something else about left-wing parties and protest movements, which is also not particularly fun. Did we keep our meat? Yeah, I'll continue using that meat. But yeah, I actually don't watch WVGCW scenario. I used to be a big fan of VGCW, but I kind of dropped off after Baza left. Can I actually continue without bait? Will I get anything? At all? Yeah, I will. Weird. This is really strange that you can just continue fishing without any bait. This is a super easy way to grind up money. Hmm. But yeah, Try, I really, really, really enjoyed watching Try. I'll probably actually watch it again over the Christmas break, just because I have nothing to do at all over the Christmas break. Part of the reason that, that me and Mikey were wondering, Novo Spirit, there's nothing in particular that we're fishing for, is that we've kind of hit the cap that we can actually raise our offense at before we accidentally raise our speed as well, over 100. And basically, I don't want to accidentally push Wanyamon's speed over 100 in case we get something other than Gomamon. Because basically how this game works with Digivolution criteria is you get what a kind of quotas that you have to meet, and if you break two quotas, then it kind of gets dodgy about which quota it takes. That's the one it's going to choose your Digivolution from. So I'm just kind of burning time until he Digivolves. He's only got about half a day left in him before he Digivolves. It's not particularly wasting any of our stats or time, because we have the training manual, and we have a lot of people who just help us raising our stats. And the stats for Banjo-Lermon are not entirely insane to get. It's only 400. I've never actually watched Samurai Jack. I think it came out when I was a bit older than the show actually aired in this country. So I was never particularly interested in watching it. Looked cool though. Had a nice animation style to it. Very weird and different. But yeah, good to hear that VGCW is still great. Wait, why am I losing all my bait here? Ah, we actually got something this time. Poof, that's it. Big one. Cool. Did not expect to get that. But yeah, good to hear that it's still going strong. I kind of fell off after Basil left because it stopped being as consistent as when it went live, and I just kind of fell behind from there. I'll probably stop fishing in a moment. Another reason why I was also fishing is just to grind up some money. We kind of have nothing in the way of money. I kind of wonder how Illidan versus Red, and Red versus Gary and Armstrong would go though. I want to track that down. Is the writing for the crappy vaccine set still as good? I never watched the developmental show either, by the way. I watched it once or twice, but I could never really get into it because it was super inconsistent on when it went live. I always missed it. Like, part of the charm for VGCW for me was watching it live. When I had nothing to do at all, because it was late at night. This is going to be a bit of a fuss to get back from. There we go. Oh god. Keep going. Good. So, what's your guys' favourite thing that's currently happening in the new Digimon Adventure Tri, then? Like, is there anything that particularly interests you in it? That you want them to follow up on? Because I really like the sort of the dynamic of Angry Matt that they've got going on. I've always been a big fan of Matt when I... Is that just a regular Digimushroom? Yeah, it is. But yeah, I've always been a particularly big fan of Matt. I don't know why. I just thought he was a cool character. I thought he was actually my preferred character of a tie, even. But yeah, I like asshole Matt. Oh my god, look at that hat on that Megadramon. He even looks sinister! Look at him! Like, it not looks sinister, it sounds sinister. Foo, foo, foo. Nobody says that. Oh, fuck you. Fuck you, Megadramon. You and your stupid system have screwed me over already. You and now you've gone and invested your illegal money into the meat market. Yeah, what a gangster. Too right. Ugh. Welcome to Tyranny Town, where Digimon lets known criminals come and live within the borders. How does he keep getting elected to leadership of, or mayor of the city? I don't know. Nobody admits to voting to Digimon. But he keeps getting elected in. Some people who live in the back alleys over the way from the meat farm started referring to him as El Presidente because he's a bit of a dictatorial character. And worse yet, he's even got people living in his basement. Digimon is he's a dictator, he's not a mayor. Look at this, he's got illegal people living in his basement. They're probably here as slaves. What are they even doing here? And he sells, oh yeah, accessories. Hey guys. Let's have some interaction here. What do you want me to buy? I'll buy an accessory. And that will be what Bancho Leomon gets to watch. And yeah, you should definitely finish Digimon Adventure PSP. Mush hat. Okay, let's get some mush hat. There we go. You know, I didn't expect Devimon to run a cloak shop, to be honest. I expected him to go for something much more illegal. Much more dodgy sounding. Alright, I like that. And... oh, nope. Double clicking it there. We have other accessories. So we can't wear another hat item, but we can wear something down here. What does Wanyamon want to be... what does Wanyamon want to be wearing? Fucking hell, he just looks like a psycho toad. So yeah. Oh no, you can wear a hat on a hat, Mateo. Hats all the way down. Yeah, we did the slow Digimushroom and we just put his head on our head. I'm really liking the Myotismon mask. Just because his eyes are just in the right place for this. It just looks creepy. What do you guys think? But we can go for any of the other ones we got. We can go for a cutie little guy over here. Or we can go for, I don't even know. Casey Jones from the Ninja Turtles. Until you guys make your mind up, I'm just going to put that on and I'm going to show off what else we can also have. Yeah. We can have Jolly Roger or a banner flag. You know what? I'm feeling the banner flag. So for the meantime. Alright, Quarnos. Let's go for that. Yeah, he looks cool down there. Mikey, you can read some basic Japanese. What does that sign say? Or anyone else who has any knowledge of Japanese. What does that sign have to say to us? In fact, let's exchange a bunch of items that we've got inside here. Swap them into our inventory and deposit all the crap that we don't need. Like, we don't need 4 bandages. I'll probably be using that. We don't need 3 restore floppy, actually. Wait, when did we get a restore floppy? Oh, I bought one after we got knocked out. Oh, okay, I'll check it out when I get a chance. Don't need the MP floppy right now. Don't need that for certain. Actually, I might just sell that. I don't think we're going to need more than one digicore, to be honest. Boosting the train, affect the HP, speed, and defense. I'll be using that. Alright, so we've got some nice training items. But yeah, basically I'm going to put all these away. I'm going to take out all the stuff that we have in here that might be useful for training. Or that I can sell right now. For example, that I can sell. That I can sell. That I can sell. Hey, we got a speed chip. Cool. I'll use that. Sell all those because we don't need that many of them. At that point, we may as well take out all the Digimushroom. Alright, so now we should have some money to work with. And I'll probably invest some in training items, to be honest. Alright, so that's one side of it. That's the other side of it. That's one. That's the other. Let me know what you think of that, Mikey. Give us a conclusion. What does this guy think is so important? Oh! Have we got a restore floppy? Actually, let's see. That's not a restore floppy. Wait, the correct side was covered with chat. Oh, sorry, I'll sort that out in a moment. I'll show you just inside the item screen. Sold. I'll never feed him those because I'm not a poor abusive parent. Wow, that's worth a lot. I'll sell them all in case we do need one. There we go, we're now rich. We have 30k. Alright. There we go. That's what the sign says. That's the other side of the sign. And now I'll go buy a bunch of training items. You know what, I should really go back and finish watching Digimon season, was it? Four, the one with Agumon back in it. This isn't the one with the dodgy alleyway. This is the one with the dodgy alleyway. I'm so bad at navigating this town. Medicine. Okay, he's a doctor of pain in the growing. Season 5, yeah. I should really go back to watching Season 5. I kind of took a... Yes, Data Squad, that's it. I kind of took a big break from watching and never went back. Is this the training? Nope, MP. Lose weight, MP. Where's our... Does he only appear at certain times? Well, hours just turned over, so maybe he's changed. Nope. Maybe it was you who sold? Oh yeah, you guys have him. There we go. That will do for the training that we're doing here. And while I'm at it, may as well buy some meat, since we're gonna need it. Probably giant meat. There we go. But yeah, I kind of left off with Digimon Savers around where they started going into the Digimon world. Couldn't really be bothered going back to it because I got really busy all of a sudden. I wish you would just digivolve already. It's irritating me now. Like, if I give him more speed, he'll just go over the limit and we'll probably get something other than Gomamon. But yeah, I never got as far as seeing much past, I think, third tier transformations at best. Anything else that we can do here? Well, bloody hell. Having a laugh, are you? But, yeah, I think the last episode that I watched was one where they fought the spider guy, whose name I do not remember. That's a really strange trophy. It's not a statue. That's a trophy. It's on a little trophy podium. It's made out of gold. Nobody makes a statue out of gold. I refuse to believe anything otherwise. Kind of in a, stuck in a situation here where I'm just gonna wait. It's annoying. A really fucked up and dark part of me also wants to go back and watch Digimon Season 2 again. I have no idea who it's supposed to be, though, Spirit. It's like the... Oh, there we go. It's like the statue in the original Digimon world. You had no idea what it was supposed to be. And there we go. Gomamon, right off the bat. And he just looks like a psycho to me. He doesn't look right. He looks angry as shit with that mushroom hat on. Looks like he's gonna go fuck shit up. In fact, while we've got a load of money... Also... There you go. You're gonna reject it. Then I'm gonna tell you off for rejecting it. You're gonna get some discipline. And then, you're gonna eat it. Yeah, since we got a load of money, I figure we may as well go buy all of the items and accessories. And we're going to need more food. Actually, in the meantime, I'll leave it for now. And as soon as I buy the accessories, I'll go back to the gym and I'll feed them the training accessories or training foods. And then from there, we'll work. Come on, controller. Stop being dodgy. But yeah, I'll just buy all of these. Teacher Brevet. Did he mean mortarboard? A I've never known a teacher to wear a beret. What is an intravenous... Why would we have an intravenous drip? That's fucked up. That's... Ew. I think we're going to run out of money before we get everything here. Yeah, we have. I want to know what the IV drip looks like now. For in case your Digimon likes to do mad drugs. I also want to know what he just says when you talk to him. Okay, not much. Wait, you had to turn it to burning... I don't even know what Burning Greymon actually looks like. Like, what are the weird Digimon that followed, or the spin-offs that followed on from after, I never really kept up with. Alright, so for Leomon we need 80 attack, 80 speed. We're already way over both of them, I believe. And 80 brains. Effect of MP, offense, and brains. Okay. Still hungry. Great. And I believe that boosts our offense by 10? Or maybe 20? Alright, so let's see what we get as a boost here. But yeah, I don't actually know what a lot of the, Digimon they added in later look like, because I kinda didn't follow it after a certain while. There should really be saves coming here. There we go. Start saves coming. I think 300 will do it for... we'll do it for offense here. No, we're not going for a Kakumon, we're going for Leomon, and from Leomon we're going to Bancho Leomon. Because basically we've already had a Darkchamon, so once we get to Bancho Leomon, we should be able to DNA Digivolve and then get a Chaosmon, which is, I believe, one of the only DNA Digivolutions in the game. I think there's about two or three of them. I should be easily capable of getting to that because, because, well, I've already done hard Digimon, to be honest. I'm good at raising monsters, guys. I swear. Please believe me. But yeah, this is largely just going to be grinding right now. It is part of a greater LP. That is currently up to 31 parts. This is probably going to just be a big part 32. You just watch me grind and talk about Digimon for a long time. It's the hardest to do, but I've already got two of the stats by an absolute mile. I only need another 12 brains and we are there. Angemon into a Lucemon. Yeah, don't worry, our weight will be below 30. We've only got 16 weight right now. Do we need any discipline? Nope. We only need 10 battles. In fact, we only need to make 3 of the quotas, so we'll need to make weight. Because weight is always first, as the quotas that you need to achieve in this game. Then attack, then speed. We've already got 2 of them, so the 3rd one should be easy. But we may as well achieve 4 of them, whenever possible. Alright, this is my worst minigame. I will be bluntly honest with that. So I'm going to save scum the hell out of it. And there we go. And of course I messed it up again. There we go. Let's see how much of a boost we actually get for that. 22. Well, we're already on the all the stat achievements that we need to get Leon on, but I'm going to say we keep going. We need 400 brains, which is a lot of brains. Nobody here needs more than 80. A Kakumon needs more than 80 brains, but nobody wants over 100, so going way above 80 shouldn't really mess up our criterias. I think there's a pause button here. Yeah, there is. I forgot about the pause button. So it is. It's free. But yeah, you're only really going to see me save scumming that much on this minigame, because this one is horrendous, and the MP minigame over here, or the HP one, Drum, because they are by far the worst minigames in the game. I'm so bad at them. I'm a save state warrior. Just gonna guess. And I got it wrong, as always. You know what, I could probably just guess it would be faster than, faster than me actually figuring it out. I know Sid Montague, but I am bad at everything, just trust me. It should be easy, but I'm an idiot. I did get really good at training brains about a month ago when I was... Stupid controller. When I was getting Dark Jumon. I could do it every time, but I've not done it at all since, because we record on a really weird schedule. If you're wondering who I mean by we, by the way, Game Kiwi in chat is my colleague, Maggie CP. I don't know what that actually means. We'll become stronger. Sure, you can eat this. Get a meaningful stat boost out of it or something? No idea. But yeah, I'm historically extremely bad at all of the training minigames that involve any sort of competency at minigames. Timing ones, I can do just fine. These ones cannot do at all. So I'll just pause, go up to 2. But yeah, there's a track record that I am extremely... That wasn't 2. God, that... See? See? My ability at this is not good, guys. But yeah, 3D Ghost Leg. My worst minigame by a mile. I'm going to say it's 2 again, but watch now as I got it wrong again anyway. No, I didn't. I do feel like the needs in this game, compared to the original Digimon World, have been ramped up quite a bit. You find yourself needing to vest far more often, or maybe it's because the minigames are far faster, so it just feels more often. But either way, I feel like grinding in this is way more tedious. And I believe that we need no care mistakes on our path to... Yeah, we can't have any care mistakes whatsoever on our path to Leomon. So, what I'm going to do is I'm not going to save from now on. I'm only going to use save states. That way I have a hard save that I can go back to should I need it. But, It's 2. Yeah. I'm notoriously bad at any kind of minigame. At all. But yeah, between getting Dark Jamon and getting Bancho Leomon, hopefully that'll put us in line to have shown off probably the hardest Digimon in the game to get. I think Dark Jamon is, by a stat requirement, especially considering the path that I took to get him, which involved going down Graumon, is far and away the hardest one to get in the game. His stat requirements are far higher than most of Digimon. If you disagree, let me know what Digimon is actually harder to get in this game. Because I am actually interested in knowing. Because I would probably try and raise it. Let's see what our weight is right now. 21. So we're on track. No, I disagree, said Montague. I got a Numemon in my very first, like, 30 minutes of this game. When I was testing it. Numemon's super easy to get, you just don't do any training. You just run around and doss about. It's hard to get Numemon from what he is into something else. Yeah, but actually getting him in the first place, not that hard. People always overhype it. At this point, we should have over 200 brains. We do. Also, there's an MP, but fortunately nobody needs MP, so we're not going on any bad tracks here. So what I'm just going to do is I'm going to raise our brains all the way up to the 400 that we need it to be at, since nobody will get us in trouble. Actually, I should probably check that. Leomon, MP. Yeah, nobody needs MP that is off of our track, so it should be easy to go from just doing 400 brains here. Actually, I'm gonna wait for you to see if you've got another bubble, because if you need the toilet and you go to sleep, that'll be this entire thing ruined. But you don't. Alright. By the way, sorry if you see me running in opposite directions. For some odd reason, my DualShock 4 controllers have suddenly decided to break. You need 3 care mistakes. It's easy to get care mistakes in this game. Very easy. Just ignore his sleep needs, and you'll probably get a Numemon. 2 again? It's always 2. Always. I should really just keep clicking 2, and it'll keep giving me 2. Also, the plus side of me just continually training brains is that eventually we might learn a new technique, which will also help us in raising Bancho Leomon, because I believe he has a technique requirement, which we're probably nowhere near. So we'll never get it, but it will make it easier for the subsequent Digimon. I've never watched Mystery Science Theater scenario. I don't think it actually ever aired in my time over here in the UK, so this is like a big black hole. The closest I actually get to Mystery Science Theater is people on the internet mocking Mystery Science, well, not mocking, imitating Mystery Science Theater. Mocking was the wrong word to use entirely. So yeah, I've never seen any of it. Imagine these days, going back and watching Mystery Science Theater will be, will actually be quite bad, because so many people have done it since, and some of them may have, I may have actually seen people who do it better than they do it themselves, since they were kind of the prototype of it all. They were the original We Are Talking Over Things guys. So people may have just improved on the formula since. But if I do decide to start watching Mystery Science Theatre, where do you think I should start, scenario? I've never seen any of it, so I can start anywhere. Did I just have the speed? Yeah, I did. I turned on frame skipping. There we go. Good to hear that a bunch of them still hold up. Manos. Okay, I'll check out Manos' Hand of Fate then. And how did I get that long? I had it paused. See, even with massive crutches, I can still get this wrong because I am an idiot. Santa Claus conquers the Martians. That actually sounds like a movie I would watch without subtitles, to be honest. That sounds fantastic. And yeah, I heard about the Kickstarter. Is that one of the most successful Kickstarters for something of that variety? Usually Kickstarters have trouble breaking 1 million. Especially if it's not something like a game or a standard product. So it's quite unusual to see something that is a TV show break 3 million, never mind 2. We no longer have any more. Yeah, I do have a super carrot. This is feeding one. Only a little. Yeah, I'll give him an anchovy and then I'll give him the super carrot. I don't think the super carrot is actually making a difference. I'll feed him two because. What? Why does he need so many? Greedy bastard, he's ate both my super carrots. I expected that to fill him. But yeah, no, we're probably not going to see its status effect. But yeah, I don't think they actually make a huge difference for us anyway. Oh, cool, you got a copy of the script. Nice. How is it they're actually, how is it they're actually doing the new Mystery Science Theatre show, then? Is it going to be like VIF Tracks, where they release the audio track and you have to track down the movie yourself? Or are you selling the actual movie with it when they eventually start back up? That kind of thing interests me quite a lot, because the legal situation of all that is grey as hell. It's a dodgy area. Actually, I have no idea what Veronica Mars is, by the way. So he's talking about something I have no idea about here. Please explain to me, what is Veronica Mars? New episodes. I mean, usually the episodes of Mystery Science Theater, didn't they commentate over an old movie? As in, they spoke over something that was not their intellectual property. That's what I'm interested in. If the episodes are they coming out with the footage as well? Or are they coming out as an audio track to put over the footage? Because it would be really interesting if they managed to get the actual footage. Especially in this day and age. Veronica Mars is a show about a teen detective. Okay, this sounds like something that is not for me whatsoever. It sounds really weird for something in this day and age. I have no idea who Felicia Day is, by the way. Am I supposed to recognize that name? Probably Google her off to the side here. That music change is always super jarring to me. Splish a day. I've not seen her in anything ever. Have I? I don't think I have. She's in Dragon Age. So obviously she's got some great credentials behind her there. Oh, here we go. Hopefully it's a Leomon. Hopefully. What? Did I do wrong? What did I do wrong, guys? Did I go over 30 weight? I think I may have gone over 30 weight. Zudomon. No, it's Zudomon, not Leomon. Kakumon needs HP 800, attack 80, brains 80. I didn't have 800 HP, but I probably went over the weight, so... Back we go. I'll keep a closer eye on that weight this time. So yeah, you may see quite a bit of this in this entire fair here. Because these games are weird and janky as hell with raising. Nah, Mikey, we're not going for a Vacmon. I actually do want to show off the Geogress thing. The DNA Digivolution. I want to see how this game handles that. Like, does it actually give us higher stats when we Digivolve again on top of that? Does it give us extra time in our life? Also, I didn't actually pay attention to the clown nose. I really should have. I think I missed out already. I guess I'll have to review the footage after this. Yeah, this time I'm gonna try and pay more attention to our weight. Also, do you control when you DNA Digivolve, or is it just a thing that happens as soon as you get it? That also interests me. Because if you control it, then theoretically you can wait out until the end of Banjo Leomon's lifetime, and then you can Digivolve again and become the DNA Digivolution and really stretch things out. And yeah, these carrots aren't actually making a difference here. I've got to make sure I'm actually using the right training item. Because knowing me, I'm not. Oh, fuck's sake. It didn't actually go to the left. Which I told it to do. I guess I didn't press the button hard enough, because that is not one of the buttons that's broken on my controller. Only 15 weight. But yeah, I had to have broken 30 weight in order to get a Kakumon. Weight and care mistakes in this game, I believe, are the priorities in terms of Digivolution. They'll consider those before they'll consider stats. That was how the old Digimon World used to work, and from some reading on the internet, from someone who did what? Orange Fluffy Sheep? I don't remember his username, I think it was Orange Fluffy Sheep. Well, his Digimon World LP did, where they broke the game into bits and looked at the code. But yeah. I think that's what happened in this game as well. Someone broke it open, and that's what they saw when they tried to interpret what the code meant. And I have no idea what that means, scenario. Is it just random text? It looks like it. It's on my TV, off to the right of me, so it's not in the right resolution. So it looks kind of blurry, and I can't really interpret it. But it just looks like VQHIL/G, which means nothing to me. But yeah, if you can choose when to DNA Digivolve, then you could really game the life expectancy. That'd be kind of strange, to be honest. I'll never cheat, Snamio. Outside of my massive fucking cheating I'm doing with the stats. But yeah. I've already used the stat chip Digivolutions, not Digivolution codes anyway, because we did not have any sort of way to efficiently train previously. Come on, controller, stop being dodgy. That is a 3. I think I'm actually trying to press the button before I unpause the game so it doesn't log that command. That's why that happened before. Also, that doesn't help. I'll probably end up buying a new DS4 controller after Christmas because, wow, this one is dodgy. I have never had it work properly the entire time I've had it. Like any sort of 3D game that I try and play where it has camera controls mapped to the analog stick, it just constantly moves the camera straight up. I think the dead zones aren't all messed up. Alright, so at this point I'm gonna save again. Just because I don't want to redo an entire whole day of training, and I'll go back to that save if I need to. See, this is what I mean. Like, I'm doing nothing here. I've never been a fan of the Xbox controller, to be honest. It's never really, felt right in my hands. I was always a Sony kid as I grew up. So I'm super used to the, DualShock controller. It's always about 17 or 18. Well, not 17. Maybe 17 or 18. Maybe 16. 16 sounds about right. I never actually owned an Xbox at all. So the replacement of the dual stick on the left, oh, not dual stick, analog stick, the movement of it up to the top of the controller, it really messes with me. I don't like the placement of it. Also, their D-pad really sucks. Xbox have the worst D-pads on the planet. They are just like a headache to use. And I play a lot of games where you actually need to use a D-pad. If given a choice in a 2D game between a D-pad and a analog stick, I'll always pick the D-pad. And obviously that won't work well with a Xbox controller because it's got the big merged one big button D-pad. Okay, so my training items were actually having an effect, because we're only getting 18 boosts there. And before we were getting 22. So, maybe I want to pay more attention. In the future. To what my items are doing. Only need food, don't you? Yeah. Only food. Alright, hopefully you should only want a super cat now. Yep, there we go. And let's check out our weight. 15. I'm gonna really need to crank that weight up. Might actually go buy a heavy strawberry at some point. By the way, if you can hear me making weird noises with my mouth as I count up the path. I don't know why I do that, it just helps. Helps in my head, guys. I need some audio cue for it all. See if I can go buy a heavy strawberry though. I know there is a shop down here that sells them, but it's only at certain times. It's the weird shop that Graumon runs in the alleyway. And that is the wrong street to be going down to find that. Classic me. I'll never be able to pick the right street between these two. I will never be able to do it. While I'm here, I may as well pick up my meat as well. I don't think I've done that. There we go. How much money do we have? Only 2,500. I find it really strange that they decided to make this area over here its own... Oh, bloody hell. Its own little screen. It seems like a real wasteful use of a screen. He doesn't have the... That's a happy mushroom. I've not seen a happy mushroom in this game yet, I don't think. Alright, see you later, Mateo. Enjoy your food, man. But, yeah. I have no idea who it is who actually sells the heavy strawberry. I know somebody does. I just haven't found them yet. Probably in the next food session I need. Did I actually sell the heavy strawberry? I thought I fed it. If I sold it, then I am a massive fucking idiot, because I intended to keep that for right now. But yeah, it's not a big issue that I don't have it. What I'll just do is that next time he needs to eat, instead of feeding him a giant meat and then a smaller item, I'll just feed him a giant meat and then a sirloin. Because that will... He will accept that and it will increase his weight as I need it. Oh, I had a happy mushroom. Okay. Actually, yeah, thinking about it. Yeah, I think I picked one up in the jungle area. So, yeah. I guess I did have a happy mushroom once upon a time. You just don't see them nearly as often as in the original Digimon World. Used to pick them up left, right, and centre in that game. Oh, I did anyway. Maybe I was just very lucky. Stupid controller. It's gonna be a real bitch using this controller when I get to... when I get to speed training. Eh, it's not a problem if it's more difficult to chat Mateo. Plus side of doing this live on the internet, because I'm talking and I'm interacting with people in chat, it means that I am not really paying attention to the music in the background. I really hate the music in this game. I don't think it's good at all. It really irritates me. Yeah, I was thinking of trying to use the Steam controller, but I completely forgot about doing it until about 2 minutes before we went live. So I was like, you know what, it can wait. What I'm going to do is, after this, I'm going to actually try and set it up. And see if I can get that running in... Or get this emulator running in Steam. It should be possible. By the way, guys, yeah, I own a Steam controller. I bought it when drunk. And I was like, alright, I guess I've got this now. See what our weight is? Alright, we're nearly there. Yeah, there's been worse drunk purchases. I actually really like the Steam controller. It's kind of odd to use, but I've gotten used to it. Like, I can happily play, say, Dead Rising with the Steam controller. I played through all of Dead Rising off the record with that controller, and it works just fine. I was a bit skeptical of the build quality of the entire controller when I first got it, but it seems to be holding up just fine. It's grown on me, I guess. Alright, we now have all of the brains that we will ever need. And I don't think we're going to get a Leomon, we're going to get a Galgamon, I believe. No, and a Kakumon? What? What? Again? Again? We didn't nearly have the weight he needed. Wait, do we have 70 discipline? We have 70 discipline. I know how we can get rid of... Oh yeah, that nose does look really goofy on that guy. So, I know how we can make it so that we do not get a Kakumon. And that is by repeatedly praising him, because Leomon doesn't have any discipline requirements, whereas a Kakumon does. So if we make it so that we cannot possibly meet the discipline requirement, then that is one more quota off the record that we cannot get. I believe we also meet the technique quota. I wish there was a way to forget techniques in this game. There we go. That should be enough to not make us get him through discipline. Let's check how many skills we have. We need 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So we got 17 techniques and we need 14 to get a Kakumon, which is bad. I guess because we're not meeting the weight requirement, we're ticking the Kakumon box by accident, because I imagine Leomon would untick that box. Not made any care mistakes. Battles. Actually, that's what we should go do. We should go make 10 battles. That should make the difference there. Weight needs to be over 30 for a Kakumon, but I believe that if we don't meet the weight for any of them, then it'll just make it whatever you have the most requirements of already. And we already have the most requirements of a Kakumon. We have all of the techniques that we need. We had the discipline, we had the brains, and the attack. So technically we're making 4 Kakumon quotas instead of 4 Leomon quotas. So I think that raised the chances of us getting a Kakumon. You gotta run some weird arcane maths in your head to be able to figure out how to play Digimon. I've never seen this guy's finishing move, so... Alright, I like marching fishes. Yeah, but I think, I don't really have the priority systems in front of me right now, I just have the requirements that I need. But yeah, basically, I think, because we met more of the priorities. I'm gonna go for the battles, because we already meet the stats, we don't have the weight yet, but we will do. We don't have the care mistakes yet. Well, we do have care mistakes, but we don't have... Rephrasing. We have no care mistakes, so we have met that quota. Is there a guy who is easier to get Leomon with? If so, I may just go right back to the beginning and just do that. In the meantime, I'll beat up guys and I should probably go get some of our healing items, to be honest. But yeah, if I get rid of the happiness or discipline, that'll get rid of one quota that we've met for Kakumon, which should hopefully make it easier to get him. Game in the system, guys. Game in the system. Alright. What is our weight? 15. I can make that weight hit the weight we need by one giant meat and a saloon. That should give us all of the weight. Nope. He was happy after that. Okay. Next feed is the one. Wrong way. The item bank's over here. Comamon. Oh, Gaumon. I'll need 4 of these. Hopefully, Bancho Leomon doesn't have any discipline requirements, otherwise it might be quite hard to get that discipline right the way back up there. I have to do some really gamey bullshit to get that up. But yeah, hopefully meeting the bonus requirements will help us out here. That is way overkill for his HP that he has. I mean, like, I guess we could go get Gaugamon, and from Gaugamon we go to Bancho Leomon, because I know that is possible. And he's injured. We do have a bandage. But yeah, I could go Gaugamon. Because from Gaugamon you can go to Gaugamon's ultimate, and from there you can go to Bancho Leomon. I do know that is possible. Because that was the original plan in this LP. Back in about 30 episodes, well, about 20 episodes ago now. With our first Mega that we got. I believe that is 5 battles. But I'll keep going in... Nah, maybe it's 6. I'll keep going until we've got 15, though, just because I don't know what the actual count is. I should have been counting these battles the entire time I was doing them. I was not. On the bright side, at least we're getting stats. Ooh, I should check what stats we're getting for this. Alright. As long as we don't get another 100 HP, we should be fine. Otherwise, we're meeting a further requirement for Kakumon. Wait, is it possible with a Kakumon? Gargumon, Matt, Gargumon. We could still... I don't know why I'm doing this. I mean, like, we don't need specifically Leomon. From a Kakumon, we can go to Matt Gargumon. From Matt Gargumon, we can go to Bancho Leomon. So if we just get a Kakumon again, then I'll just keep going. I should have really checked that. It's fine. This system works as it is. That's the most me thing I could be doing. Constantly resetting because I was not happy with the progress that I already had. We should have 17 weight, so what I'll do now is make sure we get into the weight requirement that I want by giving him this and then a sirloin. Yeah, RIP Leomon. He was discarded before he was born. Oh, he's already 4. Of course. 19 weight. This game really doesn't want me to get the weight requirement. We may not get Leomon, but we will get a variant of Leomon. I'll definitely try and go Leomon if I can. That's why I keep trying. But yeah, I know weight's very important, it just doesn't want me to get this weight. It's kind of irritating, but it's classic Digimon World. I mean, like, I can't be angry with it, it's exactly what I wanted out of the game. Something that hates me and wants to work against me at all possible times. Wait, can you get Beezlemon in this game? Or is Beezlemon Chaosmon? HP is over 800. Ah, bollocks! Oh no! I guess we're not getting Leomon, guys! Yeah, the priority system in this game is shite. It is complete nonsense. Man, this game. This game. Can you actually get Beezlemon? Yeah, you can get Beezlemon. Cool. Who can you get Beezlemon from? I didn't say shite, I said shite. S-H-I-T-E, which is... just another way of saying shit. What's wrong with your guys' baby stick arms? I have no idea what's wrong with our guys' baby stick stick arms. Ah, we only get them by beating the story. That's a shame. Another guy that's gated behind a ridiculous requirement. Yeah, I know, it's a German way to say shit. It's just that I have a crappy accent, which makes half my vowels sound like... Not vowels, half my consonants sound like other consonants. So a lot of things sound very rough. And thus, my shite can sometimes end up sounding like scheiß. Or scheiße. As the Germans, I believe, actually say it. But yeah, shite is a, just another way of saying shit. A British way of saying it. I guess you could say it's predominantly more Irish, probably. That should be enough battles at this point. And this should be the one that makes us meet the weight requirement. Let's check that out. Yeah, we're over the weight requirement. Come on, this better be a Leomon. Yeah, fun fact about the word shite. It is a word that you can say on Irish radio. You can say shite just fine, just can't say shit. I don't know why. It's a very odd rule there. So we got the weight. Have we got today's meat? I should probably make sure we've got today's meat, because we're going to need that. But yeah, if I could get a Beezlemon, I would definitely get a Beezlemon. Beezlemon's a cool guy. Hi there, weird ferret guy. Not seeing you in a while. No, Shizo I don't believe has a E on the end. I believe it's a set that way. It might do, I might be wrong, but I've only ever heard of people pronounce it as Shizo. Not entirely sure, to be completely honest. And back to my safe scumming ways. Or, like, emulator scumming ways. Should be ready to digivolve soon, actually. Make sure he doesn't need anything else. He does not. Good. Because that would actually completely ruin us right there. I wish that the... this has been one of my constant complaints with... Digimon World or... this game, is that the way it surfaces Digimon's needs is not very good. It should really be displayed as some sort of piece of the UI somewhere, like your happiness is displayed in the bottom right, where it's basically just a light that pops up when you have a need. Because the little speech bubble way of doing it, you can only really be showing one speech bubble at a time, and it can fool the player into accidentally going to sleep when he has two other needs which just haven't gone around in the queue yet. Which is a real disaster right there. You'll wake up and you'll immediately take a dump and then find out you hadn't fed your guy. Right, we'll probably digivolve. Here we go. And 3, 2, 1, Ikakumon. Of course. What a guess. Who would have seen it coming? It's almost like I've been doing this wrong the entire time. Anyway. From Ikakumon we can go to Mach Gargamon by getting 2000 HP. Great, a stat that we haven't trained at all yet. 200 defense, another stat we haven't trained. 300 speed, another stat we haven't trained. This is going to be fantastic. Let's see how many guys Bancho Leomon can be made from. Bancho Leomon can only be made from Mach Gargamon and Monzaemon. Okay. Buckle up, guys. This is going to be a long one. It's going to be a very long one. Alright, so... Mach. What is Mach Gargamon's needs? He needs... How much weight? 30 plus. At least this guy's cool. How do we want to look right now? Let's see what we can actually wear. Safety helmet. Teacher beret. I've never known a teacher to wear a beret. Oh, great, he needs 90 plus discipline. Fucking hell. Ah. Oh. Well, I guess I'm going to have to game it every single time he wants to eat now. Every single time. We had something over here. Venomon ears. Venomon isn't even in this game. Why are ears here? You know, I can have a red ribbon. And... Wait, what's Moni? Ninja tools. Okay. You know, it can be a sick, unhappy clown. Yeah, Sid Montague, I know that. I was just trying to see if I could do anything in to weight the game kind of in my favour. Because simply put, I wanted to go down the Monzaemon path since that one was easiest. Oh, it's comparatively easier. Alright, we now need 2000 HP. It's half of my least favourite minigame right here. Like, I complain about 3D Ghost Lag, but this one is even worse. You're gonna watch me do this a lot. Oh wait, there's a 7 on here somewhere. Yeah, the game is never in your favour. It hates the player. At least we don't have much HP to get. I should always just be aiming for the 7, because I know I can get the 7 every time. No, I don't want to train X-Plane. There we go. But yeah, this minigame just really, really sucks. Out of all the minigames, this is easily the worst. Alright, we've already got the 2000 HP. This minigame really isn't going to go well with the weird provoking control that I have right now. It's really going to mess me up. Because I think you can actually move the analog stick. Actually, do we only need 200 speed? No, we need 300. Just a bit more then. That's only what? 7 training sessions. I'm actually alright at the defense one. Compared to the ones that require you to follow something. And I really don't like how this game places all the... that IV pack on his back looks so silly. I don't like how this game tends to place the more advanced training systems out in the world. Like, the guys who run them should really just come and put them in the city itself. It's not much of a reward if what you've just achieved is sitting out in the middle of nowhere where you can't reach it. Alright, so I'm going to give him train effect of MP offense and brains. Nope. Cherry Radish. Wait, you can put them in the city. How do you do that? Please tell me, said Montague. I would be super interested in knowing. After you recruit the guys, are they back in the city? Where exactly in the city do they go? Otherwise, I would absolutely be using... absolutely be using those super advanced trainings. Because only intermediate training is not the same. Metal Greymon and Rosemon. We've got Metal Greymon, and I don't know if we have Rosemon, though. No, we don't have Rosemon. She needed a water move, I believe, in the volcano, which I haven't done yet. Like, we've seen Rosemon, we just haven't recruited her. No more needs. I'm doing absurdly good at this bomb trainer minigame here. Like, usually I mess it up every other try. Oh, Lilamon. Is in the arena. Oh no, I haven't done Rosemon yet then. You're right, it was Lilamon that I'm on about inside the volcano. I think we have got Metal Greymon, though. He is the guy in the... in the weird canyon place, if I remember rightly. Come on, controller. Cooperate. But yeah, we're actually almost complete with this game. We've only got two more Memorial Stella left to actually get. I'm not going to reload that state because it put us over the limit that we need. We now need 200 defense. Game or controller. Alright, Metal Greymon improves the city gym. Do we have to go beat him up inside the arena as well? Because we do have Metal Greymon. Or was that Vise Greymon? I think it was Vise Greymon. Yeah, that's Vise Greymon, not Metal Greymon. Yeah, I'd like to improve the city gym if possible. This is just a better gym to be in. It's more centrally located. You can go pick up your meat, which I don't know if I've done yet today. And you can do all sorts. It's near a toilet. It's near a shop. It's easier to get to the outside areas of the world from here. Let's prefer this gym. There we go. What is our weight back right now? 34. Hot on the path to 40 weight. In the area after the Night Canyon. Okay, we've only been in there for a few minutes because our Darkjamon died in the fight over there. Come on, game. Yeah, you should really watch the last episode of the LP. It's on the channel on YouTube that's the same name as this channel, Game Kiwi. It was going to be punch training now. But yeah, it was perfect Digimon timing, if there ever was such a thing. Alright. We've got quite a bit of defense to go. We need food. We only need 200, we're almost there. We only want to sleep and rest. Well, this does both. May as well save the game now. And I'll probably need to go get food again in a moment, since we can get that. Nice. I don't even know what Thanksgiving leftovers would be like, though, Spirit. I've never had Thanksgiving, because it's not something we give a shit about over here in the UK. Thanks? No thanks. Giving? No way. That's the UK way of life. Howimon? Oh, yeah, it really was perfect timing, with our Darkdramon dying. We were about to go beat up the Darkdramon in the snowy area. He beat ours, and we were like, alright, gonna go buy more items, gonna go back and beat him again. Or try it again. And the reason that he beat us was complete bullshit as well. You should really check that out. Our Digimon just refused to do his finishing move, which would have ended the fight right there and then. But, yeah. Basically, we were in the screen over from Darkdramon, the Darkdramon fight, and then our Darkdramon died. He faded away, basically looking at the guy. Which was just the most this game you can get, or the most this series. It's almost comedy. It's perfect timing. It's like they've coded in a way for the game to say just, no, fuck you, you're done. It's punishing taken to a whole new level. It's unfair punishing. I like arbitrary unfairness. Alright, so we're almost at the defense need that we want. Alright, we're over the defense barrier that we need. And I feel like we may as well just keep going on whatever stat we're training right now because, well, we need 400 across the board. Actually, I should probably check if anything that we want needs, or anything that can compete with us here, needs MP. Only God. Gavudamon wants MP. Wait, how can this guy turn into Gavudamon? If Gavudamon's the Digimon I'm thinking of, which it is, how does that guy turn into Gavudamon? Come on. Come on. What are you doing, game? Alright. So, we can get our MP up to 2,000. Which I should probably do. I don't remember this minigame at all. Which one is the same? Oh yeah, this one. This one's another great minigame. 2, 4, 3. Two... Not that one. It has to be the far one. There we go. Nope, I didn't hit the button in time. So what I'm going to do is... 2, 3, 4... I'm just going to pause it. Can't be that one on the right. Or on the left. It has to be the one on the right. So we can go up to 2,000 with this. The second we go over 2,500, we've met a requirement for Garudamon. Garudamon also needs 30 weight, so I believe that... Wait, what is our weight right now? Because otherwise we're going for Zudamon here. 35, so now we want to be keeping the weight down. I believe this is MP? Speed and defense. Nope, this one. Of course he didn't get full after that. He's now at 39 weight. This is bad. I guess as long as we don't meet Garudamon's requirements, which we almost do. Do we have 300 brains yet? I need to check that. We have 300 brains, fuck! This game, man. Well, I guess we're not training any more MP. HP 2000. Well, we need 4000 HP. So I'm gonna keep going with the HP. But yeah, if I'd have made this game, I probably wouldn't have included any of the minigames. Oh wait, can we not get Garudamon at all scenario? Have we not met any of the requirements for it? Okay, if we haven't unlocked it, which I don't think we have, then we should be safe. Either way, I'm going to err on the side of caution. And now we need food, and wait, I don't remember if Digimushrooms actually give weight in this game. I believe they do. But we're going to go over the weight requirement here, and we're going to be in dangerous territory because we can get a Zudomon by accident. I think we have done the Sora battles in the Colosseum. Alright, we've got all these Digimon mushrooms. They don't give weight, so we'll keep using those. This should keep our weight on track. And I should also be trying to get our discipline up while I'm here. I really have been forgetting to do that. But yeah, I think we have done the two battles that we need to do. I have no idea how long I've been going for here. 1 hour and 45 minutes. This is going to be a long upload when I finally just upload this, because it's probably just going up all in one part. Like, it's not really fair to chop this down into individual episodes and give it to you guys like I normally give it to you. Since it isn't exactly a proper episode. Can check my challenges. I'll do that just now. And also check our weight. 34. At this point, I can give him a slow loin. and a Digimushroom. That should be enough. There we go. And I'll check our messages. I don't actually remember if so is... Wait. We haven't got all the... items that come attached. I should probably just open all these. Item delivery notice. Oh, a bunch of HP chips. Oh, a bunch of defense chips. I should probably use those. Alright, no more attached items, don't think. But yeah, there's no messages from Sora here, but I'm pretty sure I've beaten her. I don't remember what Sora's Japanese name is. Actually, it'll be initials, won't it? Piermon has a restaurant? Oh yeah, she goes back to that restaurant. Oh yeah, there it is. Sorry about that. It's cold in my room. I think I probably have a cold. But yeah, I think I've beaten her once. I'm not sure if I've beaten her twice. Yeah, we can probably use some of those chips to cut off some of the training time that we've got here. Or at least make it more achievable. Like, we've got 3 defense chips, which will almost put us... Or is it 4? Which will almost put us on the defense requirement that we have. And we got a bunch of other chips. I think it was MP, which should almost put us on the MP requirement that we have. But yeah, I don't know if we fought the second server. I've definitely fought one of them. I think I may have done it in an episode with Mikey. I'm not entirely certain. It's a while back now, that is. You know what, I really agree with you guys. This Pseudomon with the red nose. I like him. I'm happy that we didn't get Liamon. I'm happy that we got this goofy walking Zudamon here. I like Zudamon. He looks like a massive dog. He just looks like a massive, chill, nice dog. I'd like to own him. Why am I so bad at these minigames? Too impatient for them. Yeah, you're right, it's not Zudamon, it's a Kakumon. Been going for 2 hours here and I'm already getting tired. Should probably make sure they're not HP chips. Yeah, they are HP chips, so I probably shouldn't be training HP, because we don't need that HP. What we need is, say, more offense. And this one's easy, so we don't really need to save Scummit. But we've already got... Wait, we've got... We've got the highest offense we can possibly have. 420. Oh. What's Smiling Apple do? We're in a bad mood. Well, because our discipline is low, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to game the system and get our discipline right back up. That was a lot of discipline right there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to feed him a regular piece of meat. Then I'm going to try and feed him another defense chip. Oh, he accepted it. save one more. Next time he wants to eat, he should refuse that defense chip. Why am I still training that? I don't need it anymore. Such an easy mini game for me now. It comes naturally. We might actually get all the stat requirements that we need for Banjo Leomon while we're still. I said it was easy and I immediately fucked it up. While we're in a Kakumon here. It's completely possible. Well, except MP, which I'm not going to train at all. Just to avoid that risk. Since we don't need any MP at all for Mac Gargamon. What is our defense overall? 320. Actually, let's try and feed him some random garbage. Alright, that didn't give him a no, it gave him a that is a bad R. Didn't work. What can we try and feed him here that we will probably refuse? Oh, he's probably not going to refuse anything, if I'm honest. I guess I'll just have to wait for his defense to go discipline to go up naturally. From good raising. Good parenthood. And I am losing form here. I was on form earlier, now I'm off form. See how much our discipline doesn't go up at all. I mean, like, he has no happiness requirement, so. What I can do is I can scold him up to 90 and then feed him that smiling apple when he next gets hungry. That should replace or recover all of the unhappiness that we gained a few minutes ago. And my controller just decided to stop working again. Completely then. Yeah, it's not working now. This is goofy and annoying. Alright, almost there. We've suddenly turned into a very bad parent. Telling them off for failing at all those bomb training sessions, even though it's entirely my fault as a coach. But yeah, next time he's hungry, feed him a smile and apple, get that happiness way back up. And now we have almost what we need. And there we go, I'm back on form. I'm back, baby. And smile and apple time. That did barely anything. Actually, what is our weight? 37, so you just get a bunch of mushrooms right now. There's a lot of juggling you need to do in these games. If you just don't happen to have the items that you need at the time, I guess it just becomes impossible. What's he need now? Sleep. Should have really checked if he needed the toilet then. It'd be really bad if he did. 19 hours of this game. Man, that's a lot of this game. Ah, phew. He needed it as soon as he woke up instead of when he went to sleep. And I should probably pick up today's food as well while I'm at it, since that is available. I'm not actually sure if I've been picking up every single day's worth of food. I haven't really been checking or remembering. Trying to think if there's anything else that we can do right now with this guy. The weird plant in the water area that we need to get down for Impmon. What move do you need to know to get that down? What technique is it? Because we have Bubble Breath and we have Waterfall. Because I'm never going to guess what that move is. A fire one, okay. Trying to think of anything else that might have move gate. Can't remember any right now. But we were training speed, but we're now on speed requirements. Or an offense requirement. Defense is almost there. Actually, can Chaosmon learn any fire moves? That's probably something I would need to know. See if I can optimize everything that I'm doing here. Doesn't matter, because I think that is enough to get us over the goalpost. Nope, not quite. No need. And now we meet almost all of the stat requirements that we have. Probably just feed you all of the slime that you could ever want. Game or controller. This controller thing is as goofy as hell. That's the right one. Alright. So now all we need is some brains. Watch now as after all this effort, we just fade away. That would be, again, a very Digimon World thing to do. Just punish me for trying to be good at the game. But we're almost there. Oh, Hailstone. Great. More moves. And Digivolution time. This better be a Matt Gargamon. Yeah, there we go. There's a happy little championship belt there across his chest. New Digimon means new accessories. Because we can barely see any of the accessories that he's got on now. Other than the nose. Boko Belly Band. Vogue Ribbon. That doesn't look very voguey. We've already had a satchel on him. I'll keep the IV drip on. It looks like an add-on to his backpack. Or his jetpack, even. But we do need something to replace this ribbon over here. You know what, I'm playing safe here. I'm using a lot of cheaty techniques to get to what I'm getting at. So we're going to have a safety hat to represent that. It's symbolic, guys. Also, stats. Did any of them go up? Brains went up a tiny bit, but we only need one more session of brains. And it is free. So, what weight do we need for this guy? 40. So, we can keep feeding him. Need techniques 50. Not gonna get that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We do need to do a lot of battles. So, we're gonna be battling this entire time. We need 8 quotas, and there's only 8 things that we can possibly achieve in this time span. So that means we've got to go out and do a lot of battling. Sid Montague, you seem to know the priority system. Does the battles include battles of that entire Digimon's lifespan, or does it only include battles that we've done in that form? I'm not entirely sure myself. 2, 4, 5, and 3. Ain't that one? It's the far right one. Battles of that lifespan. Okay then. So we are already a quarter of the way there. This shouldn't take too long. 4, 2, 3. Ain't that one. It's the middle one. We haven't made any care mistakes, so we should be good there. 4, 5, and something that I couldn't see. But it is the right one. Should probably feed him something that increases our training efficiency. 5, 2. Ain't that one. It has to be this one. Oh, the game FAQ's guide is wrong. Okay, that's comforting to know. It just says that we need 8 quotas to fulfill for Bancho Liamon, and there are 9 possible quotas you can actually fulfill. Actually, I skipped care mistakes, didn't I? That'll be why. I didn't count that, because it has a 0. We've not made any mistakes, so we should be good on that front. So weight, stats, and chemistics, that is all 8 of them right there. We're on track. Three, five, four. That's that one. Two, three, and five. But yeah, that is also very classic Digimon World right there. All the characters are wrong. Always. It could not get more classic Digimon World if it tried. Alright, so we shouldn't need more than 2 giant meats and a third item to satisfy him, so I'm just going to feed him that. And this does boost MP, doesn't it? No, it doesn't. Alright, never mind. Alright, so long as we don't go over 600 speed, we should be fine. We should only be capable of getting a... I should probably just pause this. I'll just go with this one. Fuel was correct. I didn't actually even bother checking. Only need... sleep. Yeah, you need sleep. Controller funkiness as always. Almost there. What moves can this guy actually use as well? Fighting, electronic looking stuff, and something else. Gears. So no fire moves here. You can't go get the Impmon. Are you the guy that... who went into what are the at Sid Montague, this is, that went into all the code to have a look at how it all works, because if so, I've already read it, I believe. 5, 2, and 3. There we go. But yeah, if you are that guy, then I technically mentioned you earlier in the stream, I think. If you're the guy who went into all the priority systems and all that. 5, 3, and 2. Can't be that one, it has to be that one. But yeah, go ahead and link it in chat in case anyone else who is in chat right now who plays this game would be interested. 4, 5, and 3. But yeah, I think that was you, Sid Montague. I think I've already read your post. Super helpful to know that stuff, so thank you for doing it. 2, 4, and 5. Can't be that one. Has to be the far right one. I like it when people break games up like that. It kind of destroys a lot of the mystery charm about the games, but when you're trying to do something like this, it's super helpful to just know that information. And I know that was wrong. I don't know why I did that. I think it's because I'm almost at the requirements that I need. I'm just not paying attention anymore. Also, I'm talking, so that's probably not doing me any favours either. And you know what? He can have 3 HP chips while he's at it. Get that HP nice and high. Yep, this guy's shaping out to be a very strong guy. 2, 3, 5. And there we go, we have all the stats that we need. We have all the chem stakes that we need. We have all the weight that we need. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to buy a bunch of port parties, take out our bandages, and we're going to go battle. Get any bonus requirements that we might need as well. Just for extra security. Plus, I haven't done a lot of battling and we have next no money. Actually, probably put a bunch of crap away as well. I should probably feed him this as well. What does a Digi Arowana actually do? I have no idea. They can go away as well, since we no longer need them. Only need one of those. But yeah, it'd be super useful if I ever actually knew what all the items that have, like, kind of weird descriptions do. Oh, the increase all the stats by a few. Yeah, that does sound like something you'd probably sell before actually using them. In that case, I'll just sell it. It is not worth the space in my inventory if it's only a few stat points. And that money, I'm gonna buy a few more items. There we go, now to just go beat up on some really weak guys. Make sure we got all our moves turned on as well. Get rid of Mac Jab. The Mac Jab run is over. And spin a sack. There we go. We've got 2 points now. This should be really easy and chill. Just beating up on complete chumps. We don't really need the 500 defense that we have, but why not? This is kind of cruel and screwed up, but may as well do it. Just beating up on all the weakest guys I can possibly find. Don't run away. You only make it take longer to happen. Just accept it, Hugurumon. Accept the beating into your life. That might be Hugurumon, it might be a Solomon. I can never tell the difference. Does that make me a Digimon racist? I think it does. The worst kind of racist. Okay, so that was a salt one on. But yeah, the only V colors that I ever really seem to remember the names of are the ones from Digimon World 1, like Psychmon, which is the pinky colored Gabumon. That's only because I saw those hundreds and hundreds of times as a child. And he's tired, so it's a good thing we're near the resting point. Oh, okay, I'll look out for the difference in the gears next time I look. And Sid Montague, we're going to become Bancho Leomon, which is basically a gangster Leomon. Do you think he's a good person? Do you think he's done good things in his life to get him to the point where he's a gangster? I don't think he has. Oh man, we might actually get a care mistake here if I'm not fast enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to feed us a poor potty. Because running over to the toilet might take us time. And I believe it is on the hour that this changes over to a care mistake. It might be 3 hours, it might be on the hour, but I'd rather not risk it, to be honest. You know what, we've beaten up on enough really weak guys, so now I'm just going to beat up on the kind of weak guys. I'm going to go into the jungle. No need. Good. Besides, beating up on guys in the jungle also means we can check out if there's any cool items on the ground. There's always better items in this jungle here. At least I find there are. And we might learn a move, for all I know. In fact, I should probably see if the Gerimon is in the sewer. Mikey told me about going back to see him, so I should probably check on him there. Because if he is here, Mikey said there was a boatload of items in it for me, or at least another quest. Which I'll happily go to. But he's not here. You know what, I wouldn't really want to eat the sewer mushroom if I'm completely honest with you. You know what, Andromon, you'll give us nice stats, but what is... No, I thought that was an item there. I'll beat you up. Of course, I might learn that cool move. Man, Andromon's always been one of my favourites. He's just cool to look at. Any cyborg is a cool guy. And there we go. Any moves? Please say we won. Yes, we did. Entirely worth it. Worth the items I spent on it. Give it a heavy impact. We never use it. Don't even know if Energy Ball is any good of a move. But we've got it. I will also say that this is the only place in this game where I actually like the music. A large part I dislike the music in this game. This has got a nice chill vibe to it. What does a Kakumon here want? I completely forgot about this guy. Ah yeah, we need to come back to him with a Numemon or something like that to be able to do that quest, I think. It's kind of a losing struggle trying to clean up all the filth in the toilets or the sewers. Don't know why you'd ever bother doing it. And that is an effect that I've not seen in a long time. Not many moves have that effect in this game. Oh, it's not many that I've seen. Loads in the original Digimon World did that to you. I don't think you actually need to be hungry in order to eat the filth on the floor with a spirit. In the original Digimon World, you could just walk into it with any old thing and it would do it regardless. Like your tamer would basically tell them to go eat the muck, whether they wanted to or not. Kind of a cruel thing. Not very good parenting, if I'm completely honest. What does moderate tell us to do? I think that's a better move. Yeah, it's a better move, so we should keep using that. But it doesn't have as great a range. And it's over. You know what, I'm gonna leave this place just because guys here take too much damage. They have way too many hits. I was hoping I could game him then. Yeah, it feels like a waste of MP floppies here. Even though we're probably earning better money. These battles in here are way too slow for me. Is he sleepy? Yeah, I definitely want to get out of here then. This place feels like it would be a care mistake sleeping in here. I don't remember the way out. So we're just gonna also buy our way out of here. And I think that was the last save with Darkjamon. And now he needs a toilet. Good thing I did come back to the city then. I have no idea what a toilet is in the sewers, even though the sewers are the toilet. Come on, controller. Work right. Time to see the difference between Hagurumon and Solomon, since we are in a place that I can do that now. Eh, they don't look much like Razor Sunlight. They still look like Gears to me. But yeah, being up on the easy guide feels like a way better use, well, way more efficient use of my personal time. We should be almost there in terms of battles, to be honest. Is there a counter anywhere on your page that says how many battles you've been in? Nope. I'll have to look at a picture of a Solomon then, this bit, since I guess I'm not really seeing it here. But yeah, I feel like the neutral point on this controller is all messed up. It'll turn off and then turn on. That feels like what is happening here. There isn't really a way to reset the neutral point, at least none of the ones that I've tried have worked. Like, it's really screwing me here. Like, look at this, I'm holding forwards, but he's not moving. I'm lucky he hasn't really screwed up my training at all. Go for the slow one. Let him enjoy his life. It's gotta be like 56 weight now. Maybe 54. I hate having a cold. That guy could have avoided that attack if he just stayed where he was stood. But he was nice, and he decided to speed things up for me by walking into it. Yeah, it still doesn't look like a sun to me. Maybe it's like the FedEx arrow. I haven't noticed it yet, and once I do, it'll be something I never stop noticing. I think we should have been counting all the matches that we've been in. Like, I feel like we've broken 40 at this point, but I can't really be certain. You don't need to unlock Bancho Lilmon, do you? I just realised I never thought to check that. It'd be a real shame if you do. I'd be bummed for certain. Alright, just a moment. Pause. There we go. Hopefully the controller works a little more smoothly now. Just unplugged it and plugged it back in. Not sure if you actually saw the little thing that I got. The little DS4 input mapper. Tooltip that popped up in the corner. Hopefully you didn't. Oh, that's good to know scenario. I'd be really pissed if I'd been trying all this time. For something that I cannot get at all. Beezlemon, Dukemon, got Gavudamon, Lilithmon, Monzaimon, Metal Gavumon, Seraphimon, and Wargveymon. That's a lot of guys that you need to unlock. I think that's kind of really bad design right there. Especially since the game doesn't actually tell you you need to unlock them before you try. Since you seem to know your shit with this game scenario, how many other DNA Digivolutions are there in this game that you can just get without unlocking things first? It feels like Chaosmon might be the only one. Like, I can't remember my reading of the guide if there are any others. And with that, we're almost back at full happiness. Omnimon as well. Okay. But you can't get Omnimon without unlocking something first, because you need to unlock Wargreymon. And Metal Gavurumon. So this guy is the only guy you can get from the opening of the game that is a DNA Digivolution. That's kind of silly. I don't remember what age these guys digivolve at. We're 9. So, if anyone in chat knows the actual age you digivolve at, let me know, because I'll be super interested. In fact, if you get an extra lifetime when you digivolve again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set it to that, because I have an idea of something I can do with that. We're going to revenge them. Day 6. Day 6. But we're 9. Don't tell me this guy's gonna fade away. I'll be really disappointed if he fades away. I'll be really fucking pissed off if we fade away. Oh, day 10, okay, that's... Phew! Thanks for that correction there. I was on the verge of giving up all hope for living. I was that close. That close. I just did a little thing on my hands. You can't see it. So. You know, you could probably just feed me misinformation here to try and screw with me, and it'll work every time. Since I can't trust this game for shit. Due to the way they work. At this point, I think we've almost definitely gotten the 40 battles we need. I don't blame you for lacking the patience to play this game. It's wearing on my patience. At least, the grinding is wearing on my patience. I basically play completely grind-free games these days. Yeah, I can do it. Thanks for the positive reinforcement there. I can do it. I can do this. I can win. I'm going to become Piccolo from Dragon Ball Z here. I feel like I may as well just train a bit more. Time goes faster when you train. More offense. There's never enough offense. Man, that one clip from Dragon Ball Z, it is the best clip of any anime ever. I don't watch a lot of anime. I barely watch any at all. But Piccolo's motivational self-speech that he gives is fantastic. I love it. Especially since he pretty much gets crushed, regardless of the speech. That's what Piccolo does. He just gets beaten up. He doesn't ever succeed. He just loses. No more needs. Okay. You know what? I feel like we're going to get a need the second this hour passes over. Yep, there we go. I've gotten used to the rhythm of this game. I know when things happen. But, no more needs. I expect I'm supposed to need the toilet, right? Oh, there we go. You know what? We're gonna go sleep next to the toilet. I expect this game entirely to screw me over here. I trust it so little. Trust it so little. Come on. Move. Game doesn't want me to go there. There we go. Alright. We should digivolve the second we wake up. Should. Will we? I don't know. That was a good fucking guess on my part right there. It was a real good guess. But we didn't digivolve. But yeah. I'm not even risking him going to the toilet on the floor. Not anymore. I know how this game works. I know how it thinks. I know what it's gonna do. Might be at midday that we digivolve, or at least 10 days from the hour that we started the very first form of this digivolution. I'm not entirely sure. That seems like it would be the calculation. Or at least they're the most logical ones. But I'm expecting this game to run on any sort of logic. Which is a bad idea. We meet all the stats. We meet all the weight requirements. We've not made any care mistakes. We meet the battle requirement, probably. 10 days old. Why wouldn't he have a red nose and construction hat on? Dorks? That's not the only thing he has on. He also has an IV bag on his back. Because he's very sick, and he needs help. Come on, controller, let me move. Nah, I was hoping it would let me digivolve there at the past the hour. But yeah, he's basically very scared of everything in life. Oh god, I didn't intend to pick that minigame. I meant to pick the log one. Yeah, sick in the head. Needs just food. I should probably also go get today's food while I'm at it. This control is really irritating me now. I'm happy that I'm almost done here. How long have I been going here? Almost 3 hours. Almost 3 hours of just pure grinding. This game, man. This game. It's too much. He's not gonna digivolve, is he? Yeah, it's Mac Gargamon. He's not gonna do it. I'm losing hope here. I'm losing my will to live. Everything good inside of me is dying. Because this isn't happening right now. Wait 40 plus. Battles 40 plus, mistakes 0. 4 across the board, techniques plus 50. Like, we're basically there. We're there. We're over it. We're over every single one of those barriers. Why isn't this happening? Come on. You're depressing me, game. You're depressing me. The will to live is going. We're nearly at the end of the storyline, Dorks. The reason why I'm grinding up here is because everything at the story now is at a point where anything other than a mega level won't cut it. We're basically at the point where everyone is so strong that we have to be very strong to be able to keep up ourselves. We're as happy as we can get. Come on. Oh, sorry, what? I'm just gonna give him a port party. And we're gonna go rest. And he'll probably want to sleep after that. And then he'll die. He'll probably die. Come on, game. There we go. This controller is the worst. Oh, controller issues, man. I should just junk this piece of crap. You know what, we've got food that we haven't picked up yet, so I'll go do that. If he's gonna die, at least he's gonna die with a bunch of food in my pocket. Look at that crook. Ugh. Hey, double meat. That's good to have. You know what, I'm just gonna walk straight over to the toilet. There we go. This game is not pulling any fast ones on me. Come on. Here we go. It's happening. Fucking finally. There we go. Done it. Look at him. He's... that nose! That nose. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to test it. Save the game. And I'm going to... Digimemory. Alright, that works. I know how it works now. God, that guy looks like a fucking mess. What would our stats be at this point? Unholy. Whew. They are huge stats. But yeah. Not yet. There we go. We've got things to do. Well, thanks for joining me here, guys. I've been another person. This has been the longest part, 32 of... Is it 32? Or is it 33? I'm going to go check. What part are we on? This has been part 33 of Let's Play Digimon World Re. 3 hours long. Almost 3 hours long. I've been another person. Catch you next time. And as always, keep it juicy. Oh, and I feel like I may as well throw it out here. For anyone who's on Twitch and watching this, you can find the previous 32 parts of this. He's just fist pumping like mad out there. He's fucking psyched. He's like me. He's happy right now. Look at him go. Keep punching, man. Keep punching that air. But, yeah. If you are watching from Twitch and you want to check out the previous 32 parts of this LP, go to YouTube and go to the YouTube channel Game Kiwi. The previous 32 parts are right there. And I'll probably be remastering the first episode, or the first two or three episodes, in January because I'm not very happy with the way I produced those. Just because my techniques have changed quite a lot. For example, my audio panning is fucking horrendous now. Anyway, catch you next time. Keep it juicy.